So children, as I said, Alauddin Khilji appointed official person to supervise the trade and merchants activities. The price of the everyday items which they used by the people were fixed so that the common people like us can offer them or purchase them. The shopkeepers were severely punished in case if they raised the prices of the things which were purchased by the people. So the shopkeepers were severely punished in case they tried to sell the items at the higher prices, more than the actual prices. So the prices which was fixed by the these Shahana or the supervisor to the traders and merchants, they have to follow the same price. They should not raise the prices of the amount of the goods or the things. Likewise, coming to the Tughlaq dynasty, because we come across five dynasty, isn't it? One is slave dynasty, Khilji dynasty, second one, third one is Tughlaq dynasty, fourth one is Sayyid dynasty, and the last one is Lodi dynasty. Among these dynasty, how the economy was there during the sultanates are given here. So children, now coming to the Tughlaq dynasty, what and all they came up with the rules and regulations or the policies. During Tughlaq dynasty, Muhammad bin Tughlaq raised the taxes rate in order to expand his empire, that we already know. But the peasants or the crop, agricultural farmers were not able to pay the taxes due to the lack of rain. The crops they didn't had grown properly and they put fire to the crops. All these three things know. But during Tughlaq dynasty, the Muhammad bin Tughlaq imposed strict policies on tax collection. The severity of these new tax for the when the Muhammad bin Tughlaq came up with the started introducing the new tax policies, it leads to rebellion. So the Muhammad bin Tughlaq also set up a new ministry to promote agriculture, and he gave loans to farmers. By the time of Firoz Shah Tughlaq, numerous taxes was abolished. So in simple, we can say that during the Tughlaq dynasty, in order to expand the empire and the military, in order to meet the military expenses, what did the Muhammad bin Tughlaq did? He raised the tax collection or the amount of tax on the farmers, on the land, on to the crops. But the farmers were unable to pay the taxes due to the lack of yield. And these came to know of by the Muhammad, he provided certain facilities like giving free supply of food and giving free seeds, and as well as loans to recover the losses for the farmers. But whatever the tax policy was introduced by the Muhammad was not accepted by the people. They were against the tax policies. And after the rule of the decline of the Muhammad bin Tughlaq, when Firoz Shah came into Firoz Shah started ruling, he abolished numerous taxes. Whatever the taxation policies was introduced by the Muhammad bin Tughlaq, it was completely avoided or completely removed, and new policies were brought into picture. That was done by Firoz Shah Tughlaq, that is Kharja and Kamas and Zikr. These were the taxes which he came up with for the welfare of the people. Now coming to the decline of the Sultan, it is the last topic which you are going to study in the chapter Sultans of Delhi. Here the decline is how the Sultanate, the rule of Sultanates got ended, came to an end. The last ruler of Tughlaq dynasty was Nasiruddin. As he was very weak, he was not enough competent. He was not strong, efficient ruler to rule the dynasty. So, on the event of the Timur invasion in 1398, the Nasiruddin was not able to do nothing against the Timur's attack. So, the last ruler of Tughlaq dynasty was Nasiruddin. Nasiruddin was the last ruler of Tughlaq dynasty, children, and he was not an able administrator, and he does not have any capability to rule the dynasty. He was very weak in terms of ruling the empire. So, as this was known by Timur was the founder of the Timurid dynasty in Central Asia. He was an Afghanistan ruler, and he was a descendant of Genghis Khan. So as Timur raided, when Timur attacked and plundered is another thing, but forcefully stealing the goods or the things from a person or a place. So when Timur is an Afghanistan ruler, when he came to attack the Nasiruddin, that is Tughlaq dynasty, Nasiruddin was not able to do anything against the Timur. So Timur, what he did, he attacked against the Nasiruddin and he defeated and he conquered the Tughlaq dynasty. And on his way back, while returning to his place, he raided and plundered the cities of Firozabad, Meerut, Haridwar, Kangra and Jammu. These are the places which he attacked and he conquered. Who? Timur. Timur, when he invaded India, he conquered these places. Cities of Firozabad, Meerut, Haridwar, Kangra and Jammu. These are the places which were attacked and raid. Attack, raid is nothing but attack. And plundered is nothing but stealing the goods from a place or a person. Whatever the wealth he had seen in the Firozabad, Meerut, Haridwar, Kangra and Jammu, by this he got inspired and he was wished to capture these cities. Now, coming to the decline of Tughlaq dynasty, we saw that the last ruler of Tughlaq dynasty, the third dynasty is Tughlaq dynasty, which was the ruler, named the ruler, name of the ruler is Nasiruddin. So as Nasiruddin was not an able administrator to run the empire administration, Timur was attacked against Nasiruddin. He captured the regions like Firozabad, Meerut, Haridwar, Kangra and Jammu. After the end of the Tughlaq dynasty, the Sayyid dynasty came into picture, or it was established in 1414 centuries common era by Kirzikan. Kirzikan is the founder of the Sayyid dynasty, but it was not ruled for the longer period and it was taken over by the Lodi dynasty. The founder of the Lodi dynasty was Bahlol Lodi. In which year? In the 1451 CE, the Lodi dynasty was ruled. After the decline of the Tughlaq dynasty, the last ruler of Nasiruddin, it was taken over by the Timur attack. And after the decline of the Tughlaq dynasty, children, the Sayyid dynasty came into picture. But the Sayyid dynasty, which was ruled by Kirzikan, was not ruled for a longer period or the longer duration or the longer period of time. And it was taken over by the founder of Lodi dynasty. It is the last dynasty, which we see in the Sultans of Delhi, or that Sultan Delhi Sultans period. Bahlol Lodi in 1451, he ruled the Lodi dynasty. So the Lodis were an Afghan rulers, or the Afghan dynasty. They ruled from 1451 to 1526. And the last ruler of the Lodi dynasty was Ibrahim Lodi. Ibrahim Lodi was the last ruler or the king or the sultanates. We does not call king, they are sultans. So Ibrahim Lodi was defeated by Babur. The first battle of Panipat in 1526 CE. After defeating Ibrahim Lodi, Babur went to establish great Mughal Empire. He is the Mughal ruler. Next comes, after the declines of the sultans, now we'll come to know about the how the Mughals started ruling India. So this was the how the decline of the sultans got ended and how the Mughals empire began with. So children, in today's class we studied during different dynasties how the administration was, how the society was, how the financial, in order to improve the financial status of the people, whatever the taxes they were introduced, and for the well-being of the people, whatever the measures they introduced by the different sultanates, and how the Delhi Sultanates got declined, and the Babur in the first battle of Panipat defeated Ibrahim Lodi, the last dynasty of the sultans, and Babur came up with the, in order to establish the empire, that is Mughal Empire. Thank you children, and please complete the worksheet as on the day given, and make sure that the chapter which you are studying in now onwards will be having different difficult words. Please go through the words, practices, learn properly and write neatly. Be safe and be healthy.